So we've seen two examples of polynomial of non-polynomial functions, one that includes a radical and one that includes a rational function. These last three are a little bit different. So this one is a polynomial function, and this is actually a special polynomial function. This is called the zero function. This is actually the only polynomial function that is not assigned a degree. This has no degree. We're not saying that the degree is zero here. We're saying that there is no degree at all. And why is that? Well, if you think about zero, zero times anything is zero. So technically, we could read this as zero times x to maybe the fifth, and that would be zero. Or maybe it's zero times x to the 15th, or zero times x to the 1,502nd. All of these, no matter what our value of x is, would yield zero. So this function, which is called the zero function, is not assigned a degree, because really we don't know what zero is multiplying. We don't know what power of x this zero is multiplying. So it is a polynomial function, but it does not have a degree. Now, on the contrary to that, this, which is just a constant function, is also a polynomial function, but its degree is zero. It has a degree equal to zero. And the reason why is we can think of this negative 11 as negative 11 times x to the zero power. Because if you recall, x to the zero power, that whole thing is actually just equal to one for any value of x that is not zero, right? So any value of x that is not equal to zero, if we raise it to the zero power, we get one. So g of x equals negative 11. This is a polynomial function and it has a degree of zero. And this last one, h of x, this again is going to be a polynomial function. So this is a polynomial function. But what is its degree? So the degree for this one is a little different again. If you recall back to algebra 1 and algebra 2, when we had something like this, x to the 4th times x to the 3rd, we could rewrite this as x to the 4 plus 3, right? When you take the product of two powers of the same base, you add their exponents, and so we would get x to the 7th. So we actually have to kind of apply the same idea here. So if you look at this, we have x minus 1, this quantity is being cubed. If you were to actually expand this out, I'm not going to, but if you were, you would end up with something like x to the 3rd plus something x squared plus something x plus some constant, right? It would be something x to the 3rd plus some other terms that would descend in power. But x to the 3rd would be the highest power that we would get from expanding this out. So if we take this and then multiply this expanded polynomial by 3x to the 4th, so we take this and we multiply these, that's going to give us the highest value in our powers for x, is when we multiply this 3x to the 4th times our x cubed that we got from expanding this. And so when we do that, we're going to get 3 times x to the 4th times x cubed, which is going to give us something similar to what we had here. And it's actually going to give us 3x to the 7th. So if we were to distribute this 3x to the 4th through to everything, the highest power we would get would be 3x to the 7th, which means the degree for this polynomial is 7.